trying to live in a more eco-friendly and sustainable manner in Ghana is such a struggle, but it is not impossible. And in this video, I'm going to be telling you about the habits that I have adopted in order to live a more low-waste lifestyle. Hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Janetta, aka Jetta, and on this channel, I share with you how I'm trying to live a more simple, natural, and sustainable lifestyle. So I have been living back home in Ghana for the last 3.5 years. Prior to that, I lived in Italy and in Germany, where I actually started trying to live a more sustainable lifestyle. Now, being back home is a lot harder to do that, but there are a few things that I have incorporated and maintained to reduce the amount of waste that I produce. So for me, the main issue in Ghana is actually the overabundance of plastic bags. You go to buy anything, they will give you a plastic bag, no matter how small it is. Even if it is a box of matches, you will get a plastic bag. So I try to get around this in 3 ways. The first one being reusable shopping bags. We have so many of these and we have them in different sizes. This one is made of fabric so we can wash it. And then these ones are made of synthetic material. Here we go. And each time we have to head out to buy something, we make sure that we grab one of these bags and we take it along with us so that there'll be no need for the shop attendant to give us a plastic bag to put the items in it. I would suggest that you get them in different sizes. So you have really large ones for large purchases, like when you go to the supermarket and you're doing bulk grocery shopping. And then you also get smaller ones like these that you can fold and put in your bag so that when you're on the go, you're stuck in traffic and you see something that you want to buy, you just take it out and then put your purchase in it. We have been doing this for so long now that the shops where we frequently buy things at almost know to expect that whenever we come, we will have our own bags. The second way I try to deal with the issue of plastic bags is just to reuse them multiple times. Now, sometimes you just can't get around it and you end up amassing a number of plastic bags in your house. So what we do is that we repurpose them for other things. For example, we often use them as trash bags. So instead of spending extra money to buy actual trash bags, we just reuse the plastic bags that we have at home. The second way we reuse the bags is that when I'm going to the local market, I will grab as many plastic bags as I can from the house and take it to the market with me. So when I'm buying my tomatoes, I'm buying my okra, I'm buying my garden eggs, I take out the plastic bag, hand it to the seller, and then they will put the items in it. I will reuse these plastic bags until I cannot squeeze any more life out of them, and then I really have to throw them out. My third way of dealing with plastic bags is that sometimes I'll just decline the bag when it is offered. So sometimes I do forget to take along a bag when I'm going to buy something, but if the shop is close to my house and the number of items that I'm buying are not many, then I will actually decline the plastic bag and simply hold the items in my hands and walk home. Other times I'm also moving around with my car. So when I stop to buy something, I know I'm going to put the items in my car, so I will not take the plastic bag. So these are some of the ways that I'm trying to cut down on plastic bag waste. If you have any other ideas that I could try, please comment in the section below and I'll be really happy to try it out. I'm always on the lookout for new ideas. So the second habit that I have tried to adopt is to reduce or completely stop using disposable cups. So about once a week or every other week, we like to buy Hausa Koko, which is a type of porridge and it's a really popular Ghanaian street food. And we like to buy it for the entire family. So the porridge is usually served in paper cups or small plastic bags. So on the day that we're going to be buying the porridge for the entire family, my mom, who is usually the one who buys it, will take along this huge flask and they will just pour the porridge into it instead of serving it in the paper cups and the plastic bags. Now, if you're buying porridge for yourself, I would highly suggest that you invest in one of these little thermal flasks and keep it in your bag or in your office. When it's time for you to buy your porridge, you just take it out and then they pour the requested amount into your container. Now imagine that you buy porridge 3 days a week, and if you use your thermal flask, those are 3 paper cups less that you're throwing away in a week, and that adds up. So I actually started replacing paper cups with mugs when I was living in Rome. The office building that I worked in had about 3 or 4 coffee bars, and I am an unashamed coffee junkie. I used to have about 2 to 3 cups of coffee every single day. Now one day I noticed that the trash cans outside the coffee bar were filled to the brim with paper cups. They were biodegradable cups, but still, it is trash. So I started taking my mug to the coffee bar. The first time I did that, the barista actually gave me a really funny look, but I just asked him to serve the same amount that he would in a paper cup. With time, they got used to me bringing my mug to the bar. So the third major change that I made in order to live a more low-waste lifestyle is to cloth diaper. Now imagine that every baby uses on average 5 diapers a day times 365 days over a period of 2 years, which is usually around the time that kids start to be potty trained. Those are a lot of diapers that just end up in landfills. My son is currently 6 months old and he's been in cloth diapers since he was about a month old. My 4-year-old daughter was also cloth diapered for roughly the first year. Right now, I'll just give you a really quick peek into my minimal cloth diaper essentials. So just take a look.
This box contains whatever I need for cloth diapering for one day. And I keep it in the living room so I have it handy whenever I need to change him. It's got diapers here. Here are his diaper covers. A change of clothes in case he gets too messy. Wipes. Shea butter, which I use instead of diaper rash cream. Cleansing solution and a toy to distract him whenever he gets too fussy. And then I also have this plain cotton cloth that I spread out over the sofa or on the floor when I need to change him because I do not have a changing station.
Now there's so much more on cloth diapering that I would love to cover, but that would make this video way too long. So instead, I'll be making a mini series on cloth diapering, covering all the basics on the different types of cloth diapers available, how to wash them, their pros and cons, and so on. So if you're interested in that, please make sure to subscribe, hit the notification bell so you are alerted when those videos drop. So this is what I wanted to share with you today. This is what I have adopted in order to live a more low-waste lifestyle. Comment below, let me know which of these you want to try out. Let me know what you're already doing. Give me ideas for new things that I can try. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you in the next video. Until then, take care. Bye.